Are you interested in using psychedelic plants and drugs for mind-altering, spiritually expansive experiences? Or are you intrigued about all the research supporting the use of psychedelics therapeutically for depression, anxiety, and other mood disorders? In this video, I'm going to share my first-hand experience with psychedelics, what I think about the current recommendations to use them therapeutically, and why I believe that using shamanic techniques like shamanic drumming and rattling are a better option for most people. I'm Brandi Falcon, owner of Falcon Healing Arts, where I help women overcome diminished personal power, feeling disconnected, and being anxious. And I do this with acupuncture and Chinese medicine, a high 7D energy healing, as well as shamanic healing techniques, so that they feel vibrantly healthy on every level. And for some clients, this also involves them healing their substance abuse too. And so this topic of using psychedelics has come up a few times, and I feel that it will be very interesting for you to hear my take on it. Psychedelics, also called hallucinogens, are naturally occurring plants, or they can be man-made in a lab. So we're talking about DMT, dimethyltryptamine, which is really popular right now. Also, ayahuasca, a very sacred plant whose active ingredient is DMT. There's also LSD, acid, which has been popular since the 60s, magic mushrooms as well. And I would even consider cannabis in this category, since those that have high THC do alter the mind. So all of these plants and drugs shift consciousness. They induce visions. For some people, it can help them relax, but definitely not all. And that is what I want to emphasize here, is that in my experience, it depends on who you are. It depends on the mood that you are in and what your intention is, whether you are going to have a positive or a negative experience. Now, because you know I'm a shamanic practitioner, when I say I have experience with hallucinogens and psychedelics, you may assume that I'm talking about ayahuasca. And no, that is not the case. I experimented with psychedelics in my late teenage years, before I even knew what shamanism was. This was definitely not part of my path back then, although this experience did accelerate that, I believe. What's really interesting about that time in my late high school years is that I was always very protected from drugs. They were all around me. I remember having one experience. I was very confused at a party where some kids were doing crystal meth in a corner, and my boyfriend was like, "We need to get out of here." So he was very aware, and I was very sheltered, I guess, by the people around me. And then I just started hanging out with a lot of friends who had a very good influence over me. But there were some I knew I could turn to if I wanted to have a certain experience. And for some reason, I was really interested in trying psychedelics. And again, I know now that it's because I have this propensity for shamanic work. But anyway, it was mushrooms that I did, magic mushrooms, and then later LSD. And my experience with mushrooms, the two or three times that I did it, was a pretty pleasant experience. I have some very funny and good memories of that experience, but it was because it was meant to be fun, and I made sure that my friends and I were in a very safe space. We felt totally comfortable. It didn't last that long. Again, it was all good. And so I decided, okay, I will try LSD. And so the first time I did that was at a sleepover at a friend's house, and that was okay, because again, it was a safe, controlled environment in my friend's house. Her parents were home. I have no idea if they knew what we were doing. And so even though it lasted all night, we didn't sleep. It wasn't that bad until I was walking home and everything looked and felt different. Literally, the way I saw everything in the world was different. And there was a lot of paranoia that came from that. And afterwards, it was not a good experience. But I think I forgot that part because I did do LSD one final time after that. And this time it was horrible. Absolutely horrible. One of the worst experiences of my life. Because this was now when I was in college and I went to visit a friend at San Diego State. So I was on the other side of the state in her dorm with people I didn't know. We went out for a portion of the evening, came back. I took more. So, and I'm a fairly small person. I was smaller then, I was thinner then. And it lasted for days. It lasted for days. I thought I was losing my mind. I didn't know if I should go to the hospital. I didn't know if I should call my mom and fly home early. It was bad, bad, bad. And then when it did finally, the effects were gone, because there was still some residual. Again, just seeing things in a completely different way. I have never been the same since that experience. Anyway, after that, the paranoia lasted for months, and I vowed I would never do that again. That was enough experimenting. However, there were a few times after that where I had smoked cannabis with friends at parties, and there were some instances where it was mild, just having a bit of a flashback experience going back to that time where I was on this acid trip, feeling like I was losing my mind. One time, the final time, was really bad. And then I completely went cold turkey with anything that could alter my mind. Even with alcohol, I will have a little bit here and there, but I have never become drunk in the last few decades, I would say. So it was a very clear sign my body was done with this experimenting. So what happened? Now I am in this profession where I am leaving my body consciously, seeking out a mind-altering experience in order to help myself and other people. What changed is that I embraced this desire to have this expanded consciousness, but in a safe environment, with the support of my power animal spirits and other spirit guides. So in a very safe, protective environment. I learned how to do this with shamanic training. And I have never, ever desired to use ayahuasca to have this experience. It is absolutely not necessary to take any plant substance or drug. In fact, it has been discovered that our bodies secrete DMT, and this typically happens when we are in deep meditation or having experiences like a shamanic journey, typically where we use a shamanic drum. So, using a beat like this that is fast, rhythmic, consistent, or using a rattle instead. So either one, again at this rate, will put you in a state of consciousness where you can concentrate, where your mind is free to explore. So what do I think about using psychedelics? Of course, because I have a history of using them, even though it was many years ago, I would never judge anyone for wanting to try it. And if you're just experimenting, if you're just wanting to know what the experience is like, then I would just keep a few things in mind. Make sure you are happy to begin with, and make sure that you feel safe. Apparently, lab-purified DMT only lasts 35 to 45 minutes, so maybe that would be a better choice. Again, I'm not giving you advice. These are just things to think about if you are doing it anyway. Ayahuasca tea, I believe, lasts about 6 hours, so that's a pretty long time. So know what you are getting into. Mushrooms, I believe it's around that amount of time as well. LSD can be 12 hours or more. And again, with all of these, you can have the lingering effects of paranoia, or just, again, like I said, seeing things in a different way, even after the major effects are gone. So keep this in mind that if you are worried about your emotional and mental health and you're doing this on your own, that may not be such a great idea. Now, for therapeutic use of using psychedelics, I have no opinion. If you're working with a practitioner that's going to lead you through these experiences and help you process those experiences, still, I believe that if you are working through any mood disorders, any addictions, if you're wanting to spark your creativity, induce inspiring visions, or initiate a spiritual journey, shamanic healing is a much, much better choice. It is a no-brainer, in my opinion, because again, I've had both experiences. I could see how the latter is so much better all around. It is safe. You are in complete control of the experience. You could stop drumming or ask the person who is drumming to stop at any point. You are directing the mind on this journey. You can't help what shows up in the vision, but you can still reason with your mind and you can still fully come back to your body. There are no residual effects. Once the journey is done, it is done. And you don't even need to do the shamanic journey and the drumming and rattling yourself. A practitioner like me could do it for you and just relay the information, the wisdom that I get, and then help you process and integrate that wisdom into your life for deeper healing. And I have done this successfully for many people at this point. So definitely consider shamanic healing. Instead, if you have this curiosity of having an outer body experience or just expanding your mind or starting this healing work, or even try that first, and you may decide that you don't need anything else. Now, there is just one other thing I would love for you to consider as I start to wrap up this video, something really important. We attract certain spirits to us in these altered states of consciousness because it is our soul, our spirit traveling. And so when we are having these visions, when we're interacting, it is with other spirits. That's what we believe from the shamanic perspective. That's what I believe is happening if you are using these plants or drugs, even if you're not calling it shamanic work. The spirits of the plants themselves are benevolent. These are gifts from God. But if they are altered by man, or if it is a drug created by man in a lab, if these are created or bred with a certain intention that is not benevolent, it is going to reduce the vibration of these substances. It's going to reduce your vibrational frequency. And that is going to attract in spirits who are of that lower vibration as well. So when you are leaving your body, you need to be very clear that you are staying in this higher state, this higher vibrational state, so that you are not vulnerable to attack. And I don't say that lightly, even though I don't like to induce fear. I have worked with people who have drawn in these spirits when they have had substance abuse. They were in a state of mind where they were not in their power, very low vibration, and that's where they had these attachments come in. So you want to have protection. You want to have support around you. And this is built in to shamanic journeys. There are portals that we use that have this built-in protection around them. We are traveling with our power animal spirit and meeting other spirit guides who are of the light, who are benevolent, who have our best interests in mind. And that's why this has always been a very pleasant experience, not only when I'm doing journeys for myself, but even for other people who are going through negative things. Their journeys are not negative. They're always helpful and positive because that's what my energy is going into them. So if you are interested in exploring shamanic healing, I am taking new clients both online and in my office here in Belmont, California. So reach out if you would like to schedule a free 15-minute consultation. I would be happy to help. So please let me know, friend, if you thought this video was interesting. Make sure to give it a like and share it with a friend who could use this support. I'm here every week offering wellness wisdom. Sometimes it is controversial like this, so consider subscribing to this channel if this is something that interests you. But this was definitely one of my juicier videos. You got to learn about the mistakes I made as a teenager, which obviously I learned a lot from that, and this is part of my spiritual practice now. So definitely not a mistake that I regret, but I definitely don't want anyone I love going through the same thing. It was pretty rough. So tell me below what you think of using psychedelic plants and drugs for therapeutic use. I'm super interested in connecting with you soon. Take care, friends.